Hi everyone, hope you all are doing well. So today we'll study the real life applications of data structures. We'll start by discussing about array. So what is array? Array is a contiguous block of memory in which huge amount of data is stored, right? So the application of it can be like a contact list. In your phone, you are having contacts, right? Like it is a huge amount of memory stored at one place. So it can be the application of array. Now we'll move to linked list. Linked list is collection of list, right? Which is like linked in some manner. So we'll see, for example, I'm at this page, Google Maps, and I want to go to the previous page. Then I click on this button. And then if I want to go further, then I'll go to this button and I will move forward. So this is the linking of pages, links between the pages. This is the application of linked list, as the name suggests. Linked list, the linking of pages in the web browser, the application of linked list. Now stack. Stack operation, as you all know, last in, first out. In your phone, you are having notification bar, right? So the notification which comes at the first, this means that it is at the last. Like the notification which came 2 or 3 hours before will be at the downside, right? And the notification which came recently will be on the top. So the top thing is the last one, because it came last, right? And because there are many notifications before it, that came before it. So last in, first out. The last, the notification which came last will be shown at the top and will be at the top. So this is the application of linked list. Same can be seen in emails, like the emails, which the emails which is like the email which is received recently will be at the top. And the email which is received 2 or 3 hours before will be at the last. Okay, last in, first out. Because the email which came recently is the last one, and then the emails which are received previously is the first thing. So this is the application of stack. Now queue. The operation of queue is first in, first out. So for example, if we are searching something on Google, we are sending requests, and in response we get the details, information. So this operation is first in, first out. Like if we are sending requests and then at the moment we are receiving the response, this is the application of queue. And you can also take example of if we are sending 2 or 3 emails at same time, then the email which is sent first will be received first. Like sent in the from the outbox will be received first. First in, first out. This is the application of queue. Now priority queue. As the name suggests, priority queue means like having greater priority. I'll tell you it with an example. Like you all have been to McD, right? So there's a drive through at the side of the entry, right? So the people who are coming first will be served first, as per first come first serve basis. So this is an example of priority queue. And one more example can be there. Like in operating system, if we are performing multiple tasks at the same time, then the task which is having great priority will be like executed first. For example, I am opening Chrome, I am opening my compiler, and for example there's an error, like for example my battery is low, then the laptop will shut down, it will not like stay like on because my tabs are on, it will shut down immediately. So because it is having more priority, so this is the example of priority queue. Then comes the graph. A graph is a complex network, right? So it can be seen in social media platforms. Like you are having a profile in social media, then it is a like from complex networks you are having one profile, one node. From the complex structure you are having one profile means you are having, you are a one node from the complex structure. This is a like application of graph. We can see it as a graph, and the application of graph is also seen in like maps, like the Google Maps, the GPS system, because like the shortest path is found using the Digistar's algorithm. It is very hard to spell. From the Digistar's algorithm, we are finding shortest path, and it is implemented using graph. So this is the application of graph. The real life application of graph can be seen in GPS systems. Like for example, we are finding how to go from Mumbai to Chennai. Then the Google Maps will show the shortest path by calculating all the traffics and all that. And it is done using graph. Then comes the tree. Like tree is a collection of nodes, which is having a root node, then parent nodes, then child nodes. And like you are having a file manager in your phone. Then the file manager is the root. And in the file manager, you are having different folders. And the different folders are having subfolders in it. So it can be seen as a tree data structure. So the file manager is the real life example of tree data structure. So these were the application of data structures in real life. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you.